with our gradients. One, we want to make sure we don't have any excess paint. Any excess paint we have on the canvas is going to make it harder to blend. Right, so everything should be nice and flat and even. Anything that's not, right, so if I have a little bit of extra paint right here, when I make my gradient, that's not going to blend the way that it does here, because I'm going to have less paint on my brush and more paint on the canvas of two different shades that I'm trying to then marry. So, right, if you're trying to get an even mixture, which is what the gradients are, you can't have one thing being denser than the other. Right? So, from here, we're going to start by establishing our buffer. Again, the buffer is going to go down. I want it to be thick enough that I can work on the left and on the right of it without touching the other side. So, and I'll go over it until there's no remnant of that edge between the original shadow and light. Right, it's got to be gone, and I've got to make sure the paint isn't built up. I don't want it to be thicker than the shadow and the light. But I do want it to be completely solid. So that looks pretty good to me. I don't have any lighter edges out here, and I don't have any darker edges over here. Right, so this is one shade, this is one shade, this is one shade, and this, my buffer, has these kind of ratty-looking edges. They're not too precise. Go straight up and down. I create a razor-sharp edge, which is what I'm trying to get away from. So, this could also have been created. I'm going to show this to you here. So if I put this back, this one, to the original shades, what I've in effect done by putting the buffer down. Right, so this is what this started out as. If I just kind of dance over this edge, what happens is I'm actually mixing this shade with this shade. The buffer that we put down here is actually that mixture. That's the same thing. And so when we put it down, we're splitting the difference between this shade and this shade, because these don't play nice together. They're too far apart on the value scale. But if I put something in between that halves the distance value-wise between these two, now it becomes an easier edge to manage. Right, so we want to think of this not just that we're trying to make a gradient, because that's technically what we get as a result, but it's not what we're doing. We fill a shadow, we fill a light. Each one of those is a stage, and they have nothing to do with the gradient. We put the buffer down. The buffer has to be certain things. It has to be solid. It has to be the same thickness as the shadow and light that are underneath it. And it has to have a bit of a tattered edge. That's its own thing. It has nothing to do with a gradient. It's just an application of paint. And we want to think of it that way. Before we go and start dissolving my edges, I want to make sure that this meets the criteria, right? If this is imperfect, everything that follows is now a fight. If I put my shadows and my lights down and they're not done properly, they're too thick or they're too thin, it creates a battle for every step that has to utilize what's underneath, right? So I want to make sure at each stage, I'm checking to make sure that I have met the criteria of the finished thing that I'm doing. Shadow is solid, light is solid, buffer is solid. Now, I could go in here and basically just rub this edge until it dissolves, right? It gives way. But by mixing these together to dissolve that edge, what I'm doing is I'm creating another shade. That shade is my admixture. Mm-hmm. So rather than going back and forth over that thing until I mix it, it's easier to just put the admixture on the brush. Very small amount of paint, right? And you can see, not a lot of paint. And then when I work this edge, all I'm doing is soothing the edge. I already have the mixture on my brush, so it makes it easier. And again, I'm in no rush. All I'm trying to do is get the edge to break down. So that, if you look at this edge, compare it to where we started, the second stage, and now this is starting to become a bit of a blur. Go back, and I'll do it again. And you'll notice, I don't just work my way down. I'm very careful to linger in the places and watch what's happening. If I just move down and I say, well, I raised my hand, I'm done, I did my gradient, well, you wind up with garbage. In order to do this right, you have to care about the result. I know what I'm shooting for here. I'm not just moving the brush the way an instructor told me. I'm moving the brush in the direction of a particular result. It doesn't matter what I'm doing with the brush, as long as I am moving it in the direction of the result, right? You see, so I'm fading that edge. Again, it's just more of the same. The brush isn't leaving the canvas. It's staying in contact the whole time. And how soft that is. Again, direct your attention to how sharp we started, what the second edge looked like, and now what this edge is looking like. I'll go over it one more time. And you see, I'm not laboring. I'm not broken into a sweat. I'm just managing the edge. Nice and easy, no struggling. I'm moving at a pace where I can control the marks and I can adjust in real time. From here, I don't even think I really need to do very much. Just kind of smooth this out. I mean, I've got my gradient on that side. So once that's done, on the other side, the same thing. Like if I just rub this, these two added together are my admixture. So rather than just rubbing them together, I'm going to grab my admixture. It's going to make it easier to dissolve the edge. And it's the same thing. Now notice the buffer prevents this width of my brush touching the other side. That buffer has to be thick enough that what I'm doing on this side doesn't touch what I did on this side. Right? Because these two shades do not play nice together. There's too much space between them. This has to stay in between these two. Mm-hmm. So as I'm working, I'm careful not to go over there. And again, very gentle. And see, there was excess paint in here. You can see how it's fighting back against this. Again, stage one wasn't done properly. There was too much paint. I thought I lifted enough of it, but stage one, there's too much paint right there, and you can see it. You can see the impact it has. Blending. Oh, no blending. Too much paint here. Yeah, and so I have a very soft edge again compared to where we started. Same thing. Now, this side, this is all really kind of, these are all grays. These pigments are made from the same thing, but this one isn't. This edge is very hard to work with because it's a completely different pigment.
Really?
It has different densities. Yeah, the other three grays have quite a bit of white. This has no white in it. These have white in it, all of these, but this one doesn't. So that's a lot harder to do. Now, so it blends easier. So up here is fine. I would say just down in here, I need to just kind of nudge that edge just a little bit. So from here, and it's not that I don't need you to do this, but this stuff up here and down here and up here give an illusion. Our brain connects these things, and so we can see all these little variations in here because of this stuff. So just to show, again, clean gradient, if I cover that, those hints, a pretty nice gradient there. Remember I was saying to you yesterday, it doesn't have to be absolutely silk smooth. It just has to not have defined edges. And if you look in here, there's no place in here where you could say that's exactly where the light ends and the shadow begins. Like this one, right there, that's where it happens. No question. Same with this one, it happens right there. In here, there's no defined place where I can say that is exactly where we shift from shadow to light. There's no edge in here. That's all we're looking for. Nothing more than that. And it's not that there aren't little jumps. There are little jumps. There's one back in here. It's kind of smooth up here. There's a little one right there. A little one out here. But there's no clearly defined edge where we jump from shadow into light. That's what a gradient is. Again, knowing what your goal is, right? So like when I tell you, like, this is the criteria for a gradient. The criteria is to tell you the destination. If you don't know where you're going, how do you get there? get in a car and you don't know where you're going, how will you know when you've arrived? Which direction do you drive? Mm-hmm. Map doesn't help you if you don't know the address you're going to. You have to know where you're going so that you can manage the roads as you're going. If you know that you're going someplace and it's east of you and it's in the morning, you know you're driving towards the sun, right? I mean, these are simple things. Like this, you can make sense of it if you know where you're going. Where are the destinations? So I'm going to do this one. This one's going to be a lot easier because it doesn't have this shade, right? The gray is just play nicer. So between those two shades, and again, let me start by, I want to kind of go through it again. If I mix these together, if I just play on this edge until it gives me a middle ground value, it starts to dissolve, I'm basically creating this shade. So rather than do that, I'm just going to put this shade down. And again, I want to completely bury what's underneath. That edge underneath has to be completely buried. Doesn't happen in one pass. And I'm not building the paint up. The paint will wind up being just as thick or as thin as what's underneath it when I'm done. But it does need to be solid. I'm in no rush. If I get this done right, everything that comes from it is easier. And if I don't do it right, everything that comes from it is made harder. So taking my time to make sure that it's managed properly makes sense, right? I point out to people when I paint, if you watch how slow I work in the work, you'll also notice that my paintings get done really fast. And what it is that I'm very particular about everything. So where I go over something twice and it does what it's supposed to do, I do it slow and I do it twice. Someone else does it fast, but they do it 30 times and wind up with a lesser result. So even though the marks are fast, it takes forever to get the result. When for me, my marks are nice and slow, but I only do a few marks. The marks are valuable, okay? So Now that I've got the buffer in place, again, you can see these values, they're not big jumps. If I just rub this edge, look at it give away. I almost don't even need an admixture for it. So if I don't need an admixture to blend that, when I use the admixture, how much paint do you think I need? Right? Almost nothing. I could blend that edge just the way it is. But our process requires the admixture. It's just how we work. And there's reasons for it. In this case, it's not, again, in this case, it's not really necessary. But if you develop a habit of shortcutting that, even when it is necessary, you'll probably not add it in. So we make it part of the way we think. So here, nice and gentle, and I just nudge the edge. And I'm gentle. Look at how little the brush bends under my hand. I'm not pressing. The brush is just skimming the surface of the canvas. Go back, grab a little bit more. Gently. Just skim the surface. Just a little bit more. It has this little hiccup right up in there. Move over again on this side. If I rub these two together, and again, they'll play pretty nicely. There's a little bit of excess paint in here. I can kind of see it while I'm doing this. But I can blend that as well. Again, if they blend with just a few strokes like that, how much work do you think that the admixture is going to do in there? Maybe not much. So, also, contamination. This is all over the place. We have to make sure the paint we're using is only the shade we intend. You gotta watch your palette as you do this. I work that shade into the brush so that's the only shade coming off the brush when I work. Again, here, nice and gentle. And the brush is not leaving, I'm not breaking the surface of the canvas, I'm not lifting, I'm kind of rubbing. I'm doing this. The brush never actually comes up. And you can see I'm not pressing. Back and forth. I'm watching. Like you see, I haven't moved down. This edge here isn't breaking down, so I'm sitting there managing it until it gives way. And you can see as I'm kind of going, you're seeing this paint kind of building up underneath the brush. Right? As I'm going, as I'm doing this, I'm watching it start to bead up, like here. So, which is just that there's more paint There's more of this paint than there is what I'm putting down. So, and again, but look at how little pressure. I'm just trying to mix what's sitting on the surface. I'm not trying to dig back down to the canvas. Do it again. And again, I'm just working the edge. This is almost dissolved in here. So I'll be able to move through that more quickly. In the areas that aren't completely dissolved, I'll move a little slower. But again, you see me back and forth. If this is my edge, I'm kind of moving back and forth over it, creating this kind of zigzag. Again, see a little bit of something kind of creeping in up in here. Careful about how far over I allow this to push in. But there's a gradient. And again, we'll just tape it off again, and you'll see. Not silk smooth, but clean and without any boundaries in between that read as a distinct edge. Right? There's a smooth transition in here. There's a little bit of something right here. There's a little bit of something right there. But again, where in this one I can say definitively that is exactly where we go from shadow to light. In here, it happens somewhere in this space. But you can't pinpoint it exactly where it happens. Now, I could go over this another two passes and make this smooth like plastic, like really, really smooth. But you never need more than this unless you're painting plastic. And this one, of course, is just, I mean, if we mix these together, I may as well do it over here, right? So if I mix these together here, right, these actually play really nice. I can actually just make my gradient. I mean, there's no edge there anymore at all. But again, our technique is always to put down a buffer. That value in there is our buffer shade. So, this shade looks close to this, but far away from this. It needs to be a little bit lighter. Middle ground is what we're looking for. So that's a little better. Right, so if the shade isn't correct, then it'll blend with one and not the other, right? I'm seeing edges out here, but nothing in here, which tells me the shade is a little bit too dark. It's a little too close to the shadow value. I should be able to see it equally on both sides. And again, it's barely visible. Right, I mean, that buffer barely is visible. But I want to make sure that the edge that's underneath doesn't show through. Right, I can make it out, I can see the edges. Once I have that, there is nothing that goes in between. I can go back to my original shadow. Again, very small amount of paint. And just dissolve this edge. It's gone. At the other side, I mean, I'm not even seeing it yet. It's really so delicate, gentle. But again, look, I barely bend the bristles of the brush, just skim the surface. And there's our gradient, right? I mean, that was beyond effortless. Right, so, but the expectation of what a gradient is supposed to be. If you think that it's got to be so smooth, you're going to be struggling for a long time. It doesn't have to be. And if you look around the school at all of the paintings that are on the walls, you'll see in the vast majority of them, gradients, they're no smoother than this. And in a lot of cases, rougher than this, but they look just fine in the paintings. What they do is they, or what makes them work is that there's no discernible edge inside of them. Even if they're choppy looking, no discernible edges. You can't pinpoint where you go from shadow to light, and that's all these are supposed to do, nothing else. Okay?
Yes.
Give it a spin. And you'll notice, nothing is linear as I'm working. Everything is creating that edge that wobbles. Okay? Also be careful, don't turn your brush while you're doing things. So if you work here and you turn your brush, you drop darker stuff, right? You take this, which is on this side of the brush, and this, which is on this side of the brush, and when you do this, you wind up taking this shade and putting it here, and this shade and putting it here. So be careful, never flip your brush while you're working.
I'll give it a go.
Have fun.
Thank you.
I can fill this up again.